that's good. This is the great.
Keep an eye down to one.
We were going to be a bit busy with the cat, yep. So I'd like you to liaise with him and bullshit right, right. Right. I mentioned it to Colin, but I haven't sort of set anything. Nanette, oh dear.
I think it'll be water on deck tomorrow morning.
I mean, it makes you think, what do these South Africans do when they get 25 tons of it?
Tons of it, yes.
Is anyone talking about it?
No.
out at that time.
Thank you.
Cap.
Understood, stand by. Break, break, bridge, deck, we're all set down here. If everything's good up for you, can we deploy, please?
Thank you. Der hvor vi er at undersøge, hvad der er, der sker omkring det, den vigtige del af ålens liv, hvor den skal lave flere ål og reproducere sig, som man siger.
Hvad det var, niveauet var før 1980. Og det er det niveau, vi gerne skal op på igen.
Det er multinet, og efter det, så skal vi i gang med et store net, så vi skal fange nogle, til at vi kan fange nogle ålelarver.
Jamen her styrer vi hastighed på skibet eller sådan noget. Det kan vi styre heroppefra. Fordi det er jo lidt, det er lidt anderledes end de normale togter, vi ligger og laver i dansk farvand. Der er lidt andet udstyr, vi kører med, større. Så det er jo altid spændende. Og alt muligt mærkeligt, de har fundet.
Jamen, hvor mange europæiske ål er i den her prøve? De er ikke større end en centimeter, og de er utroligt tynde og gennemsigtige. Så de står virkelig og kigger godt efter, og de skal selvfølgelig finde dem imellem mange andre ting, der egentlig ligner ålelarver.
Og kom helt herover. Så er det vigtigt, at vi udnytter ressourcen optimalt, og det fungerer virkelig på den måde. Uanset hvornår man går ned i laboratoriet, så er der aktivitet, og der bliver taget prøver hele tiden.
Vi leder efter marin sne, partikler, som samles oppe for oven i vandet. Og
så sidder jeg og er ved at kigge igennem fiskelarverne fra vores 45 minutter igennem vandet på helt ned til 200 meters dybde. Og nede i enden af den der lange, lange sok, der sidder der så en lille pose med et lille net. Og der ender alle vores fiskelarver nede. Og tusindvis af andre slags dyr. Vandmænd og krabber og blæksprutter og alt, hvad man kan forestille sig. Så noget af detektivarbejdet går også ud på at finde ud af, hvad er en ålelarve, og hvad er andre slags ålelignende larver til at mærke. Og det gør det lidt udfordrende, når man sidder med...
...cirka 20 sekundmeter, og det betyder, at vi ikke kunne fiske om det i nat. Og vi startede med at fiske her i morges igen, men nettene blev simpelthen revet stykker, fordi båden vipper så kraftigt nede i agterinden, så når man har udstyr ude, så bliver det simpelthen revet stykker på vej op, fordi båden trækker i nettet samtidig med spillet. Så nu ligger
vi... Men nu er det snart overstået. Nu er vinden på vej ned igen. At vi har jo lagt skibet i en position for at holde ligesom at støtte imod vind.
Forskellige dybder. For at prøve at måle, hvad der er næringssalt i vandet, hvad er der af alle planteplankton og dyreplankton, for at prøve at forstå, hvad det er for en fødekæde, der er grundlaget for de allertidligste livsstater af ålen. Havets økosystem fungerer. Det har jo stor betydning i forhold til den globale kulstofdynamik, og ved at samle dyreplankterne og sammenholde det med, hvad ålene har i maven, så kan man få et billede.
Djævle der. Den ene har lidt flere myomerer, altså muskel. Fibre op igennem, eller muskelsegmenter op igennem kroppen. Jeg har siddet og prøvet det at kigge på nogle af de billeder og tælle de der myomere op igennem. Og den europæiske, den skal have...
Mange er jo en hel del ålelarver, altså mange i forhold til hvor tyndt de egentlig er fordelt herude. Og det, som jeg er spændt på, vi vil nu spørgsmålet, så har vi også...
Welcome aboard. You're about to join a UNOLS oceanographic research vessel. Safety is our foremost priority. This program begins your onboard safety orientation. You'll receive additional training during your cruise. Take it seriously. Your life could depend on it. This ship is equipped to accomplish your scientific research, but working at sea can be dangerous. The ocean is a hostile environment. Wind, waves, cold water, even sea ice pose objective hazards to the lives of seamen, scientists, and technicians. While you're on board, you bear responsibility for contributing to your own safety, the safety of your crewmates, and the safety and security of your vessel. This vessel works under UNOL safety standards, state and university regulations, and U.S. Coast Guard rules that impose health, safety, security, and environmental requirements on virtually every aspect of its operation. The goal of our safety plans and procedures is to help us achieve our safety goal, to cause no accidents, no injuries to personnel, and no environmental damage. A key objective of our safety program is supporting the health and welfare of all ship's personnel. That's you, members of the science party, and the crew. Aboard this vessel, health, safety, security, and environmental responsibility are everyone's concerns. They represent a culture you are expected to live by at all times.
If you come across a fire on the ship while we're out here, there's phones all over the ship. Call the bridge 102 if you don't remember that.
Ensuring that everyone conducts him or herself in a manner that promotes the safety and security of this vessel requires clear channels of communication. Everyone on board has the right and the responsibility to report accidents, injuries, near misses, safety hazards, and defects in the ship or its operations to ensure that the ship leadership team has access to the best information available from every level. Our reporting policy requires scientists and crew members to alert their superiors about health, safety, security, or environmental issues. Only by working together can we reduce the risks that affect our workplace and the jobs we perform. The goal is to maintain effective, honest, and open communications between scientists and the ship's crew at all times. Regulations require that everyone complete a ship familiarization within 24 hours of boarding. This video begins that process. On most vessels, the chief mate serves as safety officer under the authority of the master.
If you follow me right this way, gentlemen, up the stairs. Please keep your hands on the railings at all times.
The safety officer or his assistant will give you a tour of the ship and alert you to guidelines you're expected to follow. For example, areas that have restricted access. Additionally, you will participate in an orientation that teaches you more about your specific health, safety, security, and environmental responsibilities. You are required to participate in these ship familiarization procedures. The ship's crew or the chief scientist can further direct you if you have questions about any aspect of safety or vessel operations. Some UNOS vessels operate under a vessel security plan that outlines security procedures. International law has designated three levels of threat to maritime security, or MARSEC. At MARSEC level 1, minimum appropriate protective security measures shall be maintained at all times. MARSEC level 2 requires that a heightened awareness to security shall be maintained due to the greater risk of a security incident. MARSEC Level 3 means a security incident is considered probable or imminent, so that specific security measures must be undertaken. At MARSEC Level 3, the following procedures may occur.